Well, that's something new. Leg gully in place.
He brings the ball back in. Madhushankar, that's what he does with that new ball, and hence that leg gully. You learn from your mistakes. He's reacted straight away to that Indipa, forcing Madhushankar to change his length, and maybe that length will be favorable to Litton Das. We saw the left-handers do that, especially the captain, Azmul Hussain Shanto, batting outside his crease from the moment he walked out.
Oh, straight into him. Doesn't matter whether you have the leg gully or not. Onto the pads, and the short square leg a little bit in, away from the short leg fielder, and it's chipped it straight away. So he gets his man one more time. Litton departs.
And he doesn't score, Litton Das. Now Madhushankar, he does this time and time again. Vilada Gibble, he was surprised. He's got a dolly. And he hangs on to it. Sri Lanka have got that first wicket. Again in the first over, Litton Das, he tried something different, but he falls into that trap. He's gone for naught. It's none for one.
Yeah, they had a set plan for Litton Kumar Das. You've got to give it to Kusal Mendes with those two fielders in the catching position. Nazmul Hasan Shanto, the new batter. Over ball. Now, initially, there will be movement and there is a bit of a bite hitting that top of the bat. Shanto is here because of this.
And it hits him high on the bat, too. That's why he doesn't get the timing. If not, it might have flown quickly, maybe over the fielder. Look how high it hits. That's why it just lobs.
And you got to give the credit to the skipper and the team management to set that trap for Litton Kumar Das. He was in a bit of pressure. Again, well bowled.
Just a bit of extra bounce here. This is a hit-the-deck pitch. That 122, a match-winning knock the other day. Bangladesh were 3 for 23, steadied the ship and took them home, the captain. He's having a dream run against Sri Lanka. Last three innings, 89, 90 and 122 not out.
Yeah, what an over this is turning out to be. That's a wicket maiden. Lovely, lovely start for the Sri Lankans. None for one. No change for Bangladesh. Just a single change. Donit Belalage, the left-arm orthodox, in. It's a wonderful start. That's exactly what Kusal Mendes would have hoped for. Win toss, put the opposition in, and pick up a wicket in the very first over. Two slip in place. Pramod Madhushan. Just remember, Bangladesh did lose early wickets in that match, even though they went on to win by a comfortable margin of 6 wickets with 32 balls to spare. They were 23 for 3 after 5.1 overs, and that has been the struggle. Well, both the batters, earlier we saw Litton Kumar Das and now Shuma Sarkar also batting outside his crease. To negate that swing, he opens the mark opens his mark with a single.
Bit of shape into the left hand from Madhushan. The umpire is four today. Masudur Rahman Mukul standing in his 21st ODI, and unlike the T20s, you do have a neutral umpire involved as well. Adrian Holstock in his 59th ODI. He was the TV umpire for the first ODI. They swap places. And up in the box, Richard Kettleborough, along with Andy Pycroft, who's our match referee. Down to one slip. There is a short mid-wicket in place.
Oh, could have been two down. In and out as goes to the boundary.
Najmul Hossain Shanto, the centurion from the previous game. He has a feel. Should have gobbled that. Patum Nisanka. Perfectly placed. He parries it over the bar. Onana style.
Yeah, just a touch late. Just a touch late to go and grab that catch. And he can hurt you because he's the one in form. Nicely placed. He'll pick up a couple of runs. So very important, isn't it, for teams? They want to create chances early on, and when they do create chances, you expect the fielders to back them up. Was not the case.
Yeah, there are moments where you put pressure on the opposition, where you take the initiative. You've gone and got yourself a wicket in the first over, picking up the opposition captain. Well, it's not rocket science.
Shot. That is a beauty. That is a beautiful punch down the ground. Such a lovely way to pick up his second boundary.
Now he's not holding back. Confidence high. He knows he made a mistake previously. But he also knows the ball's in his arc and he knows what he can do, Shanto. And the confidence underlined by the stride he gets into the shot.
Really big stride in. He needs to be a just hold himself back from looking to play shots early on, because he's already survived in this over. He's played a gorgeous looking on drive, and then he tries to attempt to play that cut shot, maybe just a little bit closer, and also kept tad low.
Now, if I remember right, in the first ODI, Madhushanka bowled a brilliant first over. But Madhushan, he went for 12 in the second over. And even here, he's gone to 11 now. This was the last ball. No one realized. So they've all missed an opportunity. Shanto survives. 11 for 1.
চলছে গ্র্যান্ড হিরো রমজান ফেস্ট, ইফতার হোক বা সেহরি, পছন্দের খাবার সিলেক্ট করে অর্ডার প্লিজ।
From the bat of Najmul Hossain Shanto, who scored an unbeaten 122, which is also happens to be the highest score by a skipper from Bangladesh. He can thank his lucky stars.
Athar, should he have walked?
If somebody would have appealed, somebody would have appealed. Would you have walked if you were in the crease batting, Russell Allen?
I'm not a walker, I'm a runner.
Yeah, I can understand which angle you're coming in from. I can understand that completely. Right, 12 for one. It's a kind of a surface where it just once in a while you see the bowlers pitching in back of the lane and stops. That's the first one. Couple of chances could have been dropped. And this is the one where my fellow commentator feels that he should have walked because nobody appealed.
Nobody even realized. You saw the wicketkeeper's reaction.